How to run multiple motors with a single VFD. As you might know that a VFD is used to control a motor. By controlling means that VFD can run a motor, control its speed, it can even control the motor torque, and can run the motor in reverse and forward direction. Now, the question is that if we can run the two or more motors with a single VFD, the answer is yes. Yes, you can connect multiple motors with a VFD. This video tutorial is all about this interesting topic.
Before going further into today's topic, let's see the message from the sponsor of the today's video tutorial. Most of the commonly used multimeters are designed in such a way that there are two probes connected to a multimeter. With this type of a design, it's sometimes really hard to handle and use these multimeters in the field. This problem is solved by converting one of the probe into the meter. Really easy to operate and monitor from the LCD on the positive probe. One of the really cool features of this multimeter is a flashlight, which is right in front of the red probe. Now, it is really easy to use these multimeters in the dark areas of the electrical panel. Its red probe can also work as a line tester. Its other features include contactless voltage sensing, AC and DC voltage measurement, frequency or hertz measurement, continuity and diode test. Furthermore, it has a temperature sensor to check the ambient temperature. I have used and tested this new innovative design. To buy this multimeter, the link is in the description box. Coming back to the today's topic.
In this video, we will discuss pros and cons of connecting multiple motors with a VFD. Let's see an example where we'll be connecting three motors with a single VFD. We will simply connect the three wires at U, V and W terminals of the VFD. Next, we will connect these wires at the input terminals of the first MCB. From there, the output wire is distributed to the other two breakers. Each of these MCB will be supplying the power to the individual motor. Now the three motors are connected to the VFD via MCB breakers. These MCBs are really important. Any of these motor is overloaded, its MCB will trip and it will save the VFD and keep the other motors running and in operation. It is great to run the multiple motors with the VFD, but there are some points which we have to consider seriously and think about before designing such a system. The first thing is the output frequency. As we are running a system on a single VFD, we cannot control the RPM of the individual motor. All motors will be running at same frequency and at same RPM. If your system doesn't require to change the speed of individual motor, you can use this technique. Second point is the cable length between the VFD and the motor. Usually, the recommended cable length between the VFD and the motor is 500 meters. So this means that if we are wiring the three motors, the sum of these three cables should be less than the 500 meters. The next point is the total power of the motors connected to the VFD. The sum of all motors must be less than the VFD output power. Usually, the total load power will be kept 20% less than the VFD output power. The next point is the VF mode of the VFD. We should select VF run mode from the VFD parameters. VF mode is designed to run the multiple motors on the single VFD. The next point is safety related. Don't turn on or off the MCBs for the motors when the VFD is running. This action can create imbalance in the output current of the VFD and can damage the IGBT modules of the VFD. The next really critical point is that if any of these motor is short circuit, it can damage the VFD because of the sudden and sharp rise in the output current. So for this type of application, always use the good VFD which have a short circuit protection in it. So this is how you can connect multiple motors with a single VFD. And in this session, we have discussed all the pros and cons. I hope you liked today's session. Please share, like, and subscribe this channel. Till next time, take care. goodbye.